We have continuing coverage now on a deadly accident in Pebble Beach last Sunday. Today, the attorney for the man accused of driving drunk and killing two women issued a statement in which he says that his client was not driving under the influence at the time of the crash. Action News reporter Mae Chow has the story live from our Salinas newsroom.
Dan, the statement goes on to say that Stuart Elder is deeply saddened by the deaths of Sharon Daly and Linda Larone, the two women who were in the car Elder hit, and that Elder has suffered, quote, character assassination from the media. On Monday, Stuart Elder's lawyer released a one-page statement on the fatal April 7th accident in which his client was involved. San Francisco-based criminal defense attorney Paul Neary told Action News Stuart Elder acknowledges the tragedy.
Mr. Elder had said, "My life will never be the same. For the rest of my life, I will mourn the deaths of these kind souls."
72-year-old Sharon Daly and 65-year-old Linda Larone were killed instantly when Elder's black Cadillac Escalade collided head-on with the Ford SUV Daly was driving on Slope Road near Bird Rock in Pebble Beach. 20-year-old Sylvia Gaddis was a passenger in Elder's car, and she was hospitalized with serious injuries.
Mr. Elder was not driving home from the Pebble Beach Food and Wine Festival, as media reports wildly speculated. Certainly no one furnished Ms. Gaddis any alcohol.
Elder was arrested on suspicion of vehicular manslaughter and felony DUI on the night of the accident, but was released on $430,000 bail the next day.
Our officer at scene who's investigating did arrest him under suspicion of DUI. And, you know, when we arrest somebody for DUI, typically we're looking at, there's a lot of things that lead to the suspicion. You know, one thing is odor, how the person's acting. If we perform field sobriety tests, how they perform in those field sobriety tests.
Stuart Elder took all precautions, care, and concern under the circumstances and flatly denies that he was under the influence of alcohol at the time of the accident.
You believe Mr. Elder's reputation's been tarnished?
Of course it has.
Elder's attorney says his client will be, quote, vindicated in a court of law. Stuart Elder's arraignment was postponed this afternoon. Meantime, the Monterey County District DA's office is still awaiting the blood alcohol test results and further reports from the CHP. Dan.
All right. Thank you very much, May. CHP is investigating the crash. They say it's standard protocol in fatal accidents to determine where each of the drivers were prior to the collision.
And now the latest from the Gilroy area, where phone service for hardline phones haven't been working since early this morning. Tonight, it is still unclear when it will be restored. As for the causes, well, nobody's really sure. But here is what is being investigated: vandalism at a PG&E substation on Metcalf Road sometime around 3 a.m. Transformers were damaged, hazardous material spilled, and it's unknown what's caused the damage or if there is a link to what is happening with the phones. Again, unknown when the phone service will be restored.
Couple of fires on the Central Coast overnight. First in Castroville, broke out at a business. It happened just after 12:30 this morning at the Noble Pride Roofing business near Crane. North County fire crews responded. They were able to put it out. Don't know the cause of the fire or the extent of the damage. A house fire was reported in Aromas overnight, broke out just before 1 in the morning on the 2900 block of San Juan. Five engines arrived on the scene, were able to knock it down in about half an hour. CAL FIRE says that it was unoccupied and a total loss. Investigators are working on the cause.